Welcome to FixSleep Bedtime Stories Channel, your sanctuary for relaxation, meditation, and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this journey to relaxation. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our magical sleep stories. So, let the tale begin. The Celtic Queen's Conspiracy. Chapter 1. Whispers of Treachery. In the verdant, rolling hills of the ancient Celtic lands, the kingdom of Dunmore stood proud and strong, ruled by Queen Ashlyn, a leader as renowned for her wisdom as for her courage. The air in Dunmore was crisp and filled with the scent of pine and earth, a testament to the unspoiled beauty of the land. Yet, beneath this serene facade, a storm of unease was brewing. Queen Ashlyn stood on the battlements of her stone keep, gazing out over the dense forests and distant mountains. Her keen eyes, accustomed to discerning truth from mere appearance, sensed a disturbance in the natural order. Reports had been arriving, whispers of discord sowing seeds of doubt among the tribes, unexplained raids on border villages, and a general sense of unrest stirring within the kingdom. Determined to uncover the source of this turmoil, Ashlyn summoned her most trusted advisor, Ira. Ira was not only a seasoned warrior, but also a scholar of ancient Celtic traditions and lore. Her knowledge of the old ways and her experience in navigating the complex web of tribal politics made her an invaluable ally. As the two women met in the council chamber, a room adorned with tapestries depicting the legends of their people, the air was thick with concern. Ira, with her keen analytical mind, laid out the facts as they knew them. It wasn't just Dunmore that was affected. Similar disturbances were being reported across several neighboring tribes. The situation was delicate. The Celtic tribes, though united by culture and history, were fiercely independent. The balance of power was a carefully maintained network of alliances and understandings, and it appeared someone was intent on destabilizing this balance. Ashlyn and Ira spent hours poring over maps and discussing each report in detail. They speculated on potential adversaries, but the subtlety of the tactics used suggested a deep understanding of Celtic society. It wasn't just a matter of physical attacks, it was a psychological warfare aiming to sow discord and mistrust among the tribes. The gravity of the situation called for wisdom beyond the ken of mortal rulers. It was then that Ashlyn decided to seek the counsel of the Druids, the keepers of ancient knowledge and the spiritual guides of the Celtic people. Among them, there was one whose insight and visions were legendary, the Druidess Brigid. Brigid lived in seclusion, in the heart of a sacred grove deep in the forest. Her connection to the natural world and her understanding of its mysteries were unrivaled. If anyone could shed light on the darkening situation, it was she. Leaving Ira to coordinate the defenses and gather more intelligence, Queen Ashlyn embarked on the journey to seek Brigid's counsel. Her path took her through the heart of the Celtic lands, a landscape of rugged beauty that had remained unchanged for centuries. The journey was treacherous, the roads little more than dirt paths winding through dense forests and over mist-shrouded hills. As Ashlyn rode, she reflected on the legends of her people, tales of heroes and heroines, of gods and monsters, of love, betrayal, and epic battles. These stories were the lifeblood of her culture, a testament to the strength and resilience of her people. She wondered if the current crisis would be remembered as another such tale, and what role she would play in it. After several days of travel, Ashlyn arrived at Bridget's Grove. The air here was different, charged with an energy that was almost tangible. Ancient trees towered overhead, their leaves whispering secrets in the wind. In the heart of this sacred place, she found Bridget. The druidess was an imposing figure, her presence commanding yet serene. Her eyes, reflecting the deep knowledge of the ages, regarded Ashlyn with a mix of curiosity and solemnity. Ashlyn explained the situation, her voice conveying both her concern for her people and her determination to protect them. Bridget listened intently, her expression thoughtful. She spoke of visions she had received, cryptic images that hinted at a great disturbance in the natural order. The spirits of nature were restless, troubled by the same undercurrents of discord that Ashlyn had sensed. The meeting between the queen and the druidess marked a turning point in the unfolding crisis. They realized that the threat they faced was not just a political one, but something deeper, a force that sought to unravel the very fabric of their culture and heritage. Together, they resolved to confront this shadowy enemy. Bridget would use her mystical insights to seek guidance from the natural world, while Ashlyn would rally her people and prepare to defend their way of life. As Ashlyn departed the grove, a renewed sense of purpose filled her. The road ahead would be fraught with challenges, but she was not alone. With Ira's strategic mind and Bridget's spiritual guidance, she would navigate the treacherous waters of this conspiracy. The sun was setting as Ashlyn made her way back to Dunmore, casting a fiery glow over the land. She knew that the coming days would test the strength and unity of the Celtic tribes like never before. But she also knew that her people were resilient, and in their unity lay their greatest strength. A resolution steeled Queen Ashlyn as the first stars emerged in the twilight sky. At all costs, she would confront this plot head-on and defend her people. She would make sure the story of the Celtic queens ended in victory rather than tragedy, even though it was only getting started. Chapter 2. The Druid's Warning. Deep within the ancient forests of the Celtic lands, where the veil between the earthly and the spiritual realms was thin, the druidess Bridget sat in quiet meditation. Her sacred grove, a sanctuary of ancient oaks and whispering streams, was alive with the energy of the earth. The air was filled with the scent of moss and wild herbs, a testament to the unspoiled sanctity of this place. Bridget, revered among the druids for her wisdom and deep connection to the natural world, was troubled. Her visions, usually clear and guiding, had become clouded and ominous. The spirits of the forest, with whom she communed daily, spoke of a great imbalance, a darkness spreading across the land, threatening the very essence of Celtic culture and harmony. These disturbances in the natural order were not mere coincidences, Bridget knew. They were symptoms of a deeper malaise, a conspiracy that sought to unravel the threads of unity among the Celtic tribes. The harmony between nature and the people, a cornerstone of Celtic belief, was being undermined by an unknown force. As Bridget emerged from her meditative trance, her resolve hardened. She must reach out to Queen Ashlyn, a ruler known for her wisdom and strength. The queen, if anyone, would understand the gravity of the situation and the need for immediate action. Bridget prepared for her journey. She adorned herself with symbols of her office, a cloak of deep green, embroidered with sacred patterns, and a silver amulet that bore the emblem of her grove. Before leaving, she performed a ritual, asking for guidance and protection from the spirits of the forest. Her journey to Dunmore was a reflection of the land's troubled state. The forests, once vibrant with life, now seemed subdued, their animals scarce and their birdsong muted. The streams, which used to run clear and bright, flowed slowly, as if burdened by an unseen weight. Upon reaching Dunmore, Bridget was met with a sense of urgency. The kingdom, usually bustling with activity, was on high alert. Soldiers patrolled the walls, and the people moved with a sense of purpose and concern. Bridget was swiftly ushered into the presence of Queen Ashlyn. Their meeting, set in the queen's private chambers, was a convergence of two powerful forces, the political and the spiritual. Ashlyn greeted Bridget with respect, aware of the druidess's revered status and her connection to the forces that govern their world. Bridget shared her visions with the queen, tales of disrupted natural order, of whispered warnings from the spirits, and of her sense of an impending crisis that went beyond mere political intrigue. She spoke of the need for unity, not just among the people, but between the people and nature, the core of Celtic life. Queen Ashlyn listened intently, her mind racing through the implications of Bridget's words. The problems she had been facing, the unrest and discord among the tribes, suddenly took on a new and more ominous dimension. It was not just a matter of defending against an external enemy, it was a struggle to preserve their way of life. The queen shared her own experiences and the information gathered by Ira. The patterns were clear, someone was manipulating events, exploiting the deep-seated connections and beliefs that held their society together. This enemy was not just attacking their lands, they were attacking their identity. Ashlyn and Bridget, joined by Ira, formed a council of war, not in the traditional sense, but a war for the soul of their culture. They needed to act swiftly and decisively. Their first step was to strengthen the bonds among the tribes, to counter the growing sense of mistrust and disunity. To this end, they decided to send envoys to the neighboring tribes, not just as diplomatic gestures, but as bearers of a deeper message, a call to unity and a warning against the unseen enemy. Bridget, with her spiritual authority, would be crucial in this endeavor. Her presence would lend weight to their words and serve as a reminder of the common bonds they all shared. The trio also recognized the need for more tangible actions. They began planning a series of gatherings, meetings where leaders and representatives from various tribes could come together, not just to discuss the threat, but to reaffirm their commitment to each other and their traditions. As the plans took shape, Bridget, Ashlyn, and Ira felt a renewed sense of hope. The task ahead was daunting, but they were not alone. The strength of their people, their shared history and beliefs, would be their greatest weapon. Bridget, before leaving to begin her part of the mission, performed a ritual in the presence of Ashlyn and Ira. It was a plea to the spirits of the land, a request for their guidance and protection. As the incantations echoed through the chamber, a sense of power and purpose filled the air. The three women stood together, a symbol of unity in the face of adversity. They were ready to confront the conspiracy that threatened to tear their world apart. It was a battle that would require not just physical strength and political acumen, but a deep understanding of their cultural roots and a commitment to preserving the harmony between their people and the natural world. As Bridgie departed Dunmore, her figure disappearing into the twilight, Queen Ashlyn and Ira stood watching. They knew that the days ahead would test them in ways they had never imagined. But they also knew that they were fighting for something fundamental, something worth every effort and sacrifice, the soul of their people and the future of their land. Chapter 3. Shadows and Alliances. The dawn broke over the Celtic lands, casting a golden light on the dense forests and rugged hills. Queen Ashlyn, along with Ira and Bridget, prepared for a journey that would take them across these ancient lands, seeking to forge alliances against the growing shadow of conspiracy. Their first destination was the Kingdom of Morven, ruled by Queen Siobhan, a fierce warrior known for her strategic acumen. The journey was fraught with danger, the paths through the forests known only to those who had traversed them for generations. Ira, with her knowledge of the land, guided them through hidden trails and across secret passages. As they traveled, they encountered signs of the conspiracy's work. Villages were on edge, with rumors of spies and treachery abounding. In one hamlet, they found the aftermath of a raid, houses burned, and the air thick with despair. The villagers spoke of attackers who moved like shadows, leaving chaos in their wake. Queen Ashlyn, seeing the fear in the villagers' eyes, addressed them with words of encouragement and solidarity. She promised that those responsible would be brought to justice and that the Celtic tribes would stand united against this threat. Her words, sincere and powerful, left a lasting impression, sowing seeds of hope in the hearts of the people. Upon reaching Morven, the trio was greeted with caution. Queen Siobhan, aware of the turmoil spreading across the lands, was initially skeptical of their intentions. However, as they shared their discoveries and insights, Siobhan recognized the gravity of the situation. The discussions that followed were intense. Siobhan brought forth her own experiences, tales of subterfuge and sabotage that mirrored those of Dunmore. The pattern was clear: a concerted effort was being made to destabilize the Celtic tribes from within. Together, they devised a plan to strengthen their defenses and to communicate more effectively amongst the tribes. They agreed on a system of messengers and signals, a network that would allow them to share information swiftly and securely. Ira, with her tactical expertise, suggested training select groups of warriors who could move quickly and respond to threats anywhere in the territories. These warriors would be the first line of defense against the conspirators' machinations. Bridget, meanwhile, proposed a series of rituals and gatherings, events that would reinforce the spiritual bond between the tribes. These gatherings would serve as a reminder of their shared heritage and the strength they derived from their unity with nature and each other. The alliance with Morven was just the beginning. From there, the trio journeyed to other kingdoms, each with its own unique challenges and perspectives. In some, they were met with open arms, the rulers eager to join forces against the common threat. In others, suspicion and fear had taken root, and it took all of Ashlyn's diplomatic skill and Bridget's spiritual authority to break through the mistrust. As they traveled, the trio also gathered clues about the identity of their adversary. They heard tales of a shadowy figure, a master of deception who seemed to be everywhere and nowhere at once. This figure, they learned, was using ancient knowledge and dark rituals to undermine the tribes, twisting the very traditions and beliefs that were the foundation of Celtic culture. Their journey was not just a diplomatic mission, it was a voyage of discovery. They delved into the mysteries of their own culture, unearthing ancient legends and forgotten lore that shed light on their current plight. They learned of a prophecy, one that spoke of a time of great turmoil that would precede a new era of unity and strength. This prophecy, it seemed, was unfolding before their eyes. The challenges they faced were not just external. The journey tested their resolve and their faith in their cause. Ashlyn, Ira, and Bridget each grappled with their own doubts and fears, even as they presented a united front to the world. There were moments of despair when the weight of their task seemed too heavy to bear. But there were also moments of triumph, small victories that bolstered their spirits and renewed their determination. As they traveled from kingdom to kingdom, the network of alliances grew. Each ruler they met added their strength to the cause, their unique talents and resources forming the pieces of a greater whole. But even as their network expanded, the shadow of the conspiracy loomed larger. The trio knew that time was against them. They needed to uncover the identity of the mastermind behind the chaos and put an end to their schemes before it was too late. Their journey brought them to the rugged coastlines, where the sea met the land in a tumultuous embrace. Here, they encountered a group of seafarers, known for their skill in navigating the treacherous waters. These seafarers spoke of strange ships seen in the mists, vessels that appeared and disappeared like ghosts. Putting the pieces together, Ashlyn, Ira, and Bridget realized that these ships were part of the conspiracy, likely used to transport agents and supplies for the orchestrators of the chaos. This discovery was a critical piece of the puzzle, a clue that could lead them to the heart of the conspiracy. The final leg of their journey took them to the sacred Hall of Avalon, a place of great spiritual power. It was here that they hoped to find the final answers they sought. Avalon was a place out of time, a realm where the natural and the mystical merged into one. The Isle was guarded by a sisterhood of priestesses, custodians of ancient wisdom and keepers of the Isle's secrets. Upon their arrival, the trio was taken to the heart of the Isle, where a gray oak stood, its branches reaching towards the heavens. Beneath this tree, in a ceremony steeped in ancient tradition, they sought the guidance of the spirits. The ritual was a powerful experience, one that left them with a sense of clarity and purpose. The spirits spoke in riddles and visions, but the message was clear: the key to defeating the conspiracy lay in understanding the true nature of their adversary. Armed with this knowledge, Ashlyn, Ira, and Bridget prepared to return to Dunmore. The journey ahead would be the most dangerous yet, as they sought to confront the mastermind behind the chaos. They sensed that the decisive battle was drawing near as they sailed out of Avalon, the sea covered in mist and the air heavy with the tension of an approaching battle. They were the only ones who could tip the balances in favor of peace and unification, and their fate rested on their shoulders. The shadows and alliances they had navigated had brought them to this point. Now, it was time to face the darkness and bring light back to their world. Chapter 4. Unmasking the Foe. The journey back to Dunmore was filled with a tense anticipation. Queen Ashlyn, Hyra, and Brigid, armed with the knowledge and alliances forged across the Celtic lands, were ready to confront the heart of the conspiracy that threatened their culture and way of life. The trio's first task was to consolidate their forces and information. They convened a secret council with the leaders of the allied tribes, sharing their discoveries and planning their next move. The council took place in the Great Hall of Dunmore, a room steeped in history and tradition, its walls adorned with tapestries depicting the legendary feats of Celtic heroes. The atmosphere was electric, a mix of determination and apprehension. Each leader brought their own insights, and a picture began to emerge of a highly organized conspiracy, one that was deeply rooted in the Celtic lands and had infiltrated several key positions in various tribes. The mysterious figure behind the unrest, they learned, was a disgraced former chieftain named Kieran. Once a respected leader, Kieran had been exiled for crimes against his own people. In the shadows, he had nursed his grudge, building a network of followers who shared his resentment and desire for revenge. Kieran's plan was diabolical in its simplicity. By sowing discord and turning the tribes against each other, he hoped to weaken them to the point where he could seize control, unopposed. His knowledge of the Celtic traditions and politics made him a formidable adversary. The trio and their allies devised a strategy to expose and confront Kieran. They would need to act swiftly and decisively, striking at the heart of his operation before he realized that his identity had been uncovered. Hyra, with her strategic mind, coordinated the movements of their forces, planning raids and interventions at key locations where Kieran's followers were known to operate. These swift actions put Kieran's network on the back foot, disrupting their plans and communications. Brigid, meanwhile, used her spiritual authority to rally the people, dispelling the fear and mistrust that had taken root. She led a series of rituals and ceremonies, invoking the unity and strength of the Celtic spirit. These events, held across the lands, rekindled a sense of hope and solidarity among the tribes. Ashlyn, as the unifying figure, worked tirelessly to maintain the alliance, mediating disputes and ensuring that the focus remained on the common enemy. Her leadership was a beacon of light in a time of darkness, inspiring our people to stand together against the threat. The climax of their efforts came when they received intelligence about Kieran's location. He was hiding in a fortified stronghold in the mountains, a place that was steeped in ancient lore and considered impregnable. The siege of Kieran's stronghold was a formidable undertaking. The Allied forces, comprising warriors from all the tribes, gathered at the base of the mountain, ready to face the final challenge. Hyra led the tactical planning, devising a plan to breach the stronghold's defenses. The battle was fierce, a clash of steel and wills under the shadow of the ancient mountains. The Celtic warriors, united in their cause, fought with a ferocity and courage that echoed the legendary battles of their ancestors. Inside the stronghold, Ashlyn, Hyra, and Bridget confronted Kieran. The former chieftain, now cornered and desperate, was a sight of fury and bitterness. He railed against the trio, accusing them of betraying their own people by opposing him. The confrontation was tense, a battle of words and wits as much as it was of arms. Kieran, for all his cunning and bitterness, was no match for the unity and determination of the trio. In the end, he was captured, his plans unraveled, and his followers disbanded. With Kieran's defeat, the conspiracy was exposed and dismantled. The tribes, once on the brink of war, found a new sense of unity and purpose. The alliances forged in the face of adversity remained strong, a network of mutual support and cooperation that would endure for generations. The aftermath of the conflict was a time of healing and rebuilding. The tribes worked together to repair the damage done by the conspiracy, both physical and spiritual. The ceremonies led by Bridget played a crucial role in this process, helping to heal the wounds of mistrust and fear. Ashlyn, Ira, and Bridget emerged from the ordeal as heroes, their names celebrated in songs and stories across the Celtic lands. They had not only defeated a formidable enemy, but had also strengthened the bonds between their people. The story of their struggle and triumph became a part of the rich tapestry of Celtic history, a tale of courage, unity, and the indomitable spirit of a culture that had withstood the test of time. As peace returned to the land, the trio looked to the future with hope. They had faced the shadows and emerged victorious, their alliance a testament to the power of unity and the enduring strength of the Celtic heart. The sun set on the Celtic lands, casting a warm glow over the forests and hills. In the villages and halls, people gathered to celebrate, their voices raised in song and laughter. The darkness had been vanquished, and a new era of peace and cooperation had begun. Ashlyn, Ira, and Bridget stood together in the Great Hall of Dunmore, surveying the assembled multitude. They had overcome the biggest obstacle of their lives and come out stronger as a result. Along with peril and discovery, their voyage had also been one of growth and companionship. As the celebrations continued into the night, the trio knew that their story would be told for generations to come. They had written a new chapter in the annals of the Celtic people, a chapter of unity and triumph in the face of darkness.